sunny days are the absolute worst for video. There's such a huge shadow. So last week, the Norwegian Consumer Council filed a report called Every Step You Take. The report is against Google, and they are complaining that Google is violating European privacy laws. Since then, six other European nations have joined this appeal to the BEUC, which is a collection of 43 consumer councils across Europe. I went through the report real quick, and here's what I found. They seem to be complaining about one central issue, and that is, how do you measure free consent? A quick word about Google's business model. It's an unconventional one, where its suppliers are actually its users. Back in the day, they used to provide access to their search engine, and the only way they could track who's using the search is by using your IP address. Today, however, users use phone more and more, and Google uses this data to sell. So the data that Google collects, it uses this to help big businesses, small entrepreneurs, including your baker and the supermarket around your house, to increase their sales. Google helps them to reach their targets for a fee. And this is what they call ad revenue. The report I was speaking about has two central issues about free consent. The first one is web and app activity, and the second one is nudging. The overall idea is Google is using deceptive design or deceptive language in order to collect more data without telling their users that they are doing so. The web and app activity is turned on by default in your phones, and Google says that you can turn this off when you're setting up your phone. I didn't do that, so let's see if I can turn it off. I looked it up on Google's webpage. I'll leave the links to these web pages in the description below so you can look up how to do this. I'll show you how I did it to turn my location history off. So Google said, go to settings, go to Google account, go to data and personalization, go to location history and turn it off. So Google calls this pause location history. I hit pause. So now all location access should be turned off. So all location data can be turned off. What's the big deal? What was this Norwegian Consumer Council complaining about? Life's fine, right? Actually, I went to the website where they were speaking about this, and I discovered a couple of things. This page says, when location history is turned off, your settings for other location services on your device, like Google location services and find your device, is not changed. Some location data may continue to be saved in other settings like web and app activity as part of your use of other services like maps and so on. That means what I just did is useless. All my data from the past of where I've been traveling to is still on Google. To check that out, let's quickly jump into Google Maps and see what they know about my movements. I'm not going to turn on my GPS for this, but I'll show you what it looks like. I have to, when I open Maps, I can go to Menu, My Timeline. It gives me per day where I've been and so on. So Google knows where I took the picture and so on. So this data is not gone. It's still there. So what did I just turn off, and why is this data still here? Turns out that Google does not delete all of your location data, and if you want to, you can do this yourself. But in the page that we just saw a short while ago, do you remember it said your web and app activity is turned on? I looked that up, and here's what I found. What is saved as web and app activity? Your location, your language, IP address, whether you use a browser or an app, is saved as web and app activity. The ads that you click or the things that you buy on an advertiser site is saved over here. Information on your device, like recent apps and contact names that you've searched for on your device, is saved over here. Now, there's no way to turn this off, and that's what the Consumer Council from Norway was talking about. Google responded saying that you can turn things off, but it turns out you can't really turn things off. This agreeing to web and app activity is after a sequence of next, 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 and then there's an agree, which is deceiving because the user doesn't know what he's agreeing to. And when he doesn't know what he's agreeing to, that should not be considered as free consent. That's the first gripe they had. The second thing they were talking about is nudging. In case you turn the web and app activity off when you were setting your phone up and you were using Google Maps for whatever reason, Google keeps nudging you to turn your GPS on while you can still use Google Maps without using GPS. They are saying that you're turning on GPS, but they're actually turning on web and app activity. They also spoke about the design language and how it's different in iOS and Android, but I don't think that's so important. I think I have to agree with the Consumer Council that they don't really tell you what they're collecting, and there's no way you can turn it off. I was not so concerned about this to start with, because I don't mind Google using my data to target better ads towards me. But looking at how deceptive their language has been and not telling you exactly what they're doing when they're doing what they're doing, that kind of raises eyebrows. Tell me, what do you think about this? How do you feel about what we just spoke about? Let me know in the comments if you're fine with this, if you're not fine with this. I actually used a couple of other search engines, and the quality between Google and them is not so different. Google set this template, you know, that all your web results are here, your images, maps, videos, books, and so on are in tabs up there, and everyone seems to be following the same template because it seems to be working for Google. They seem to be working fine, but we are kind of intertwined with Google because their services are so awesome. What do you guys think about this situation? Let me know in the comment section. Thank you so much for watching this video. Take care of yourself, guys, and keep learning. It's the middle of December in the north of France. The sun is up and shining. The skies are clear. Pretty improbable for this area. Such a beautiful day to go outside. Really thankful for how beautiful this place is. Thank you so much for watching this video, guys. Take care of yourselves, and I'll see you next week.